Sometimes these are so rusted on that they don't want to come out easy. So you just have to work on it a little bit. This guy's really trapped in there good. Yeah, he was rested in there really good, so it's a little bit of trouble trying to get him apart. Sometimes it happens. Out now. Out of. Okay. Cylinder doesn't look too bad in there. Nice and, you know, nothing really bad. Not anything really serious. A little bit dark, it's okay. I had a bunch of water in there too, or no gasoline. I'm taking off the ignition coil right now. So, this is hard too. This thing is really, really, really does not want to be taken apart, but the thing is that when they get back together and everything, they're going to be so much better with new gaskets and everything. Thank you. there we go. This thing has a little bit of grit to it or something like that. You know, I don't know if this is steel or if this is porcelain or something like that. But I think it's steel. I hope it is. But it feels like kind of glass or whatever. Not really that strong. It kind of felt like I wanted to crack in my hands. I hope I didn't make it crack or anything. I try to take it apart as best I can, very, very gently. But I wound up freaking pounding on it like a maniac. It was unfortunately, glued together really bad. I just did not want to come apart. But I got a feeling this has never been apart before since it's ever been made. So it's been together for quite a while. Okay, it all looks pretty good. It's just really dirty, really oily and stuff. Man, it's just really gunky. But I'll just go ahead and put this in my parts cleaner stuff and for a couple hours and it'll be looking beautiful like it was. So, no big deal. A lot of the times I like to try and get the gaskets off in one piece if possible. Then I can go ahead and retrace them and cut out a new gasket for it. There's not too much carbon buildup on there. It's not too bad, so that's good. Anyway, this looks like in pretty good shape and stuff. It's just really dirty, really gritty. I think what happened is that they must have ran it without any filter and stuff, and all the air particles got in, all the dust particles got in, and like they're kind of building up, and looks like it, the gas and the oil and all the dust particles got on here. And it just feels really gritty. It's like there's a bunch of sand in here. So yeah, this is all like sand or dirt or something, like really, 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 really small particulates that's been in here, that got in here, what it is on a blower and stuff, it picks up what it is because it blows the stuff. It throws a huge volume of air and dust and stuff like that out in the air. And then if you don't have, you don't have your air box, or you're missing a piece, or like if you don't have a filter in your air box or anything, all the air that the blower blew up in the first place, it all comes back into the carburetor, straight through the carburetor and into the engine, and it just kind of affects it. And that's probably why, I don't know, maybe it just didn't run anymore, but it's really, really dirty.